In this illustration, we'll study about heat dissipation and parallel combination of two charged capacitors. Here you can see this figure shows two capacitors, 3 microfarad and 2 microfarad charged to 20 volt and 40 volt respectively. And these are connected as shown. And we are required to find the amount of heat dissipated on closing the switch S. Here, first we can calculate the initial charges on capacitors, which are charged on the first capacitor. I'm taking as 3 microfarad. It will be CV, that is 3 into 20 because it is charged to 20 volt. This will be 60 microcoulomb. The second capacitor, which is 2 microfarad, again the charge is CV, that is 2 into 40 because it is charged to 40 volt. This is 80 microcoulomb. And simultaneously, we calculate the initial energy stored in these capacitors, initial energy in the first capacitor and initial energy in the second capacitor, that can be taken as half CV square. So it is half, C is 3, V is 20, this is 20 square. And the value calculated is 600 microjoule. Similarly, for the second, it is half, C is 2, V is 40 square. So here half CV square is equals to 1600 microjoule. So initial energy in the two capacitors in total, we can sum up this. And this gives us the total energy is 2200 microjoule. Is the total energy stored in these capacitors before closing the switch. So if we close the switch, we can write, on closing the switch S, if we calculate the final potential difference across capacitors, this final potential difference can be given as total charge on the two can be taken as 60 plus 80, it is 140. Because the two positive sides are together and negative are together. So on the combination on left hand side, total charge is plus 140 and on the right hand side, it is minus 140. So it will be 60 plus 80 divided by, in parallel, the capacitance is 5. Because we know the potential difference, we can write as Q by C. So charge is 140, capacitance is 5. So this equals to 28 volt. That is the potential difference across the two after connection. So here we can write final charges on capacitors are, this Q1 final we can write as again CV, that is 3 into 28, this is 84 microcoulomb. And for the second capacitor, it is 2 into 28, that is equals to 56 microcoulomb. So for the first capacitor, if we calculate the change in charge delta Q on first capacitor plate, so this will be 84 minus 60, that will be 24 microcoulomb. For the second capacitor, delta Q2 is 80 minus 56, that is 24 microcoulomb. That has to be same because from 1 F, charge is reducing, it is going only onto the other one, so it should be same. And the final energy stored heat we can calculate in the system will be half multiplied by 5 multiplied by 28 square, that is half CV square. The numerical value is 1960 microjoule. Now, if we calculate the heat dissipation, as there is no battery, heat dissipation can be written as the loss in energy stored in the capacitor, that is UI minus UF. So this 2200, which was the initial energy, minus the final energy is 1960 microjoule. So this can be directly given as 240 microjoule. That will be the answer to this problem. And alternatively, we can also calculate heat by the direct expression we have studied, that is summation of delta QI whole square by twice of CI, where I is equals to 1 to 2 because there are only two capacitors here. This also we can calculate. Delta Q for both of these capacitors is 24. So this 24 whole square by 2 into 3 plus this 24 whole square by 2 into 2 because the capacitances are 3 and 2 microfarad. If you simplify, this will also result the same value, 240 microjoule. So either of the ways you can use to calculate the heat dissipated in capacitor circuits.